lead, but only 6,000 is not too bad. It's probably mainly because Ace, despite not doing too much right now, has a pretty solid network.
Yeah, it's still on top as the Meepo, but not near as on top as it used to be. G getting very, very farmed up to 8.8k net worth. Shoving out this bottom lane, and Meepo not really able to contest him too well, as he does have the Remnant back, so Meepo never really able to catch him until he has that Hex, but able to force him onto the lane at the very least, so Meepo picking up, sort of walking him and forcing G to TP back to base, so using all of his Remnants, not able to...
There's the Spite of Fist with the Searing Chains, and they will find yet another. It is now Dream still alive for that score.
At the very least, the Meepo still pushing bottom, does get it down to about 1/3 HP.
Oh, you find him. The Dream is dead. As Noya takes down Seema, the Dream for 3-2-2 is dead, and we continue on, and we do see the possibility of Baby Knight going down. He's gonna get very low, he'll fall. And actually off camera, Ace is gonna get a kill on Dit-Yorah. Oh, 5-21, they get two pretty solid kills on the side of C9, but they lose Baby Knight and their Centaur has to Joe.
Yeah, Meepo does find the Luna farming out pretty far down in this up in this top lane, so we'll getting a kill, and that's really, really good for him. He's working on that Hex, so whenever he has that, he's gonna be able to set up pick off some Ember Spirit, especially, you know, hopefully continue to be able to pressure this Luna. There's actually a Midas and a Blink Dagger on Enigma, though. And two minuses on Dire. You really want these supports to scale, so they're not so easy to burst down, but if we can get some more saving items, mag going for a beacon, whenever he has that. BKB or his Black Hole be uncancelable, so makes it very hard for this Meepo to play in these team fights because of these huge ultimates. The Winner's Curse, he'll be playing super far back in every fight. The BKB Black Hole on Mag, and looks like they just want to chill and farm that. Farm the BKB, I've had the BKB at Dit-Yorah, get the BKB on Mag, and look for any pickoffs all they can, but
Radiant's bottom tower
not in a big
attack.
Hurry right now, as Unite is still quite poor, working towards that match style, but it's really the
Dire's middle tower
is under attack. Bright spot for Cloud9 right now.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Yeah, Vega. It's tough to see them losing out on this game as they are so far ahead. They are going to use Winter's Curse, not going to get the kill on Ace. So maybe without the Winter's Curse, they still have to avoid the black hole. Maybe C9, and as I say that, they lose Noya once again in the mid lane. Maybe C9 look for something on Vega, knowing that they can't be hit by that Winter's Curse. And Ace is here with Hesta Joe. There's the black hole coming in from Mag. That'll stop Ace in his tracks. And they will find yet another kill on Vega towards this Meepo Ace. Just disregard everything I just said.
Yeah, the Meepo going down, so a nice, using the black hole, but as Nets don't cancel TPs anymore, they don't cancel black holes, they don't cancel anything channeling, so I think we're not having to worry about that. Getting this black hole off then. You can see, immediately after they get that kill, Sneeko moving down to the bottom lane, G as well. They're continuing to get out these lanes, then just immediately book it to the next closest hero and try and get
Dire's
these pickoffs, not give up an inch.
Under attack.
Maybe Midnight.
With the stun and the magnetized, G coming in with the Remnant, Searing Chain, Sight of Fist, Baby Knight dead again. G having another amazing game, this time at 11-1, they'll get the deny on their own tower down low. And now still has to go up, Top might be in a little bit of trouble, he's gonna try and use that ult, but Malphis keeping him nearby, has to Joe in a little bit of trouble, there's the Lucian Beam trying to turn it around, does get that hookstomp, not gonna land on Dit-Yorah. They're trying to run away. Meanwhile, on the back end, it looks as though G might be trying to do some work on Noya. And G is here with Seema. Seema's gonna end up going down. Noya in a bit of trouble. He's gonna use that ice cast, try and TP out, and no! Not gonna get it. G finds another. He's now 12-1, and three are dead on the side of C9.
It's getting close to finishing up the Daedalus. Meepo almost with the Hex, so sort of Cloud9's.
Ace might find Mag. Should be a bit of an easy kill as he's all by his lonesome, and he will get one. But on the back end of that, Ryze will fall, and Ziggurat's gonna use that BKB. He's gonna rain down hell with that Eclipse, and Ace will fall. Maybe not gonna use that Blade Fury to try and get out. G is here with Sinnoh and Ziggurat. Either blend that Lucent Beam. There's the Veil. There's the Lucent Beam. Cut a bit, as well as the Searing Chains. G finds another. And it is just looking very bad for the side of C9 as Vega want to close this out 2-0.
Yeah, for every pickup that Ace is getting, finding some Malone hero and bursting the down with all the meepos, Vega's finding a big team fight and getting a lot of kills. G getting super farm now, having the Battle Fear and the Chrysalis, so on par with meepos' net worth finally.
Look down low, Sanko might be in a little bit of trouble. There's the hook stop as well as the double edge. Sanko gonna try and walk over out. There's the ult with the Searing Chains gonna stop this Centaur and keep Sanko alive. So G gonna throw the Remnant into the river, gonna turn around despite a fist with the Searing Chains. He's not gonna have to use that Remnant as he should be okay.
Just continuing to push out here, but Vega's teamfight is just so strong. This Enigma last pick, I don't think Cloud9 saw it coming at all, but banned out the Darkseer and took the next best thing in an AoE stun. Just AoE control, does sort of the same thing as the Vacuum. Gives them a point for all their AoE damage to go. Hero that does very well in lane. Overall, this Enigma pick sort of just sealed up Vega's draft as being very, very strong. And once again, Cloud9 having to play very, very pristine. Take these fights super well, find the pickoffs, have great lanes, and Vega having some really nice rotations, getting several kills in this top lane, and Ziggurat probably getting a lot more than Cloud9 wanted him to, as he is at 12k net worth now, so not very shut down this game.
Ziggurat had the opposite of what he's having this game, last game, and now they're up 10,000 net worth, they're up 29-7. It seems like it's in the bag for Vega, but you can never say it's in the bag. Games can always turn around in the blink of an eye, but what do C9 need to do to turn it around? They're down 10,000 net worth. They seem to be losing every team fight they engage in. Do they just sit back and farm and hope, or what kind of maneuver do they go in next?
They want to continue to split the map with this Meepo. He has the Hex now, so has the real Meepo with the Hex on bottom, along with the Jakiro, so they can pressure these towers extremely well. They have several ways to cancel TPs. They have Stomp, they have Disruption, they have Ice Path, they have the Hex. So, looking to isolate Vega in places, maybe bait them into an aggressive push, and then push, take their towers, but it looks like they've actually spotted the Meepo, but immediately getting out, realizing they've spotted the Minoya walking away as well, so it looks like they won't lose anyone here. So very nice split pushing from Cloud9. Just continue doing things like this. They TP the Meepo up the top, bring one back down to bottom. They may actually lose G here, as you can definitely pick him off if he gets a hop of him, but Ace decides to play it safe, go away, thinking his game is probably there.
Yeah,
Mag setting up top.
Mag might be in a little bit of trouble. Hesta Joe is going to be spotted. There's the Malphus, but turning around is Baby Knight. They might be looking to go in on this. Mag, we're going to keep Hesta Joe near. Coming in with the TP is Ditura on the back end. Baby Knight has to jargon that run away as Vega is here. Out is Ace and Baby Knight with the Blade Fury and TP out. Hesta Joe might fall. He's might be the sacrifice, but he will blink into the trees. Oh. And TP out. So nobody falls on the side of Cloud9, and like you said, they need to get done to slowly crawl themselves out of this hole and get themselves back into this game when they're down 10,000 net worth.
Yeah, they're still pushing very effectively. It's very hard not to drop any heroes versus this Ember Spirit catch, the Earth Spirit with a Blink Dagger, the Enigma with a Blink Dagger as well. So Cloud9 doing a very good job in the situation they're in, constantly getting these lanes up. Not falling at all.
Meepo might get a kill on G, who's gotten in a little bit too far. There's the Winter's Curse. He's gonna get a kill on Noya, but still G might be in a little bit of trouble. He's gonna Remnant out. They just lose Noya. And they almost get themselves a kill on G, but Ace, he's lucky to get away with his life after that Winter's Curse.
Yeah, I think Seema maybe misclicking slightly. Maybe meant to click one of the Meepos and have him kill himself, but still okay. They do get on the Jakiro, and immediately after that pickoff, we're gonna go for the Roshan.
Black Hole comes out on Ace. Ace might be in a little bit of trouble, and by a little bit of trouble, I mean he's dead. And they lose Ace again, and that is a big halt in the step of C9 as Vega looks to grab this easy Roche without Meepo trying to defend.
Nope. Dambril up to level 22 now as well, so has the cooldown reduction. Getting close to the extra Searing Chains duration. Gonna be very, very nice versus this center ult. Him in place, even while they have a Stampede. Yeah, with this Aegis, Mansa onto Jura, Vega's just gonna look to continue to control the map and farm up, get an item advantage so that they can eventually take a teamfight near the base, get some of these tier 2s, get the shrines down, and break high ground. Gaunite continues to slip push, not take these big fights, as
Noia might be
very hard for
trouble. And avoid that stun, does put the fire down to Mag, Jura, and Snakeguard here. There's the Lucian Beam in, there's the Magnetize even, and Sento will find a kill. All five are here for the side of Vega. They're still looking for more. They might be looking for Ryze, but it doesn't look as though they're going to find it, as he does get just out of the way of that Sleight of Fist Searing Pains.
Yeah, Ryze just barely living there, but they do catch Noia. Gotta get all their lanes out, as Hestijo running up the top to shove this out immediately. Seema sitting around mid, maybe looking to scout someone out, but Vega just getting all these lanes in and continue to control the map.
The TP, Seema's gonna be spotted by Ace, easy kill there.
Yeah, and that's the kind of stuff they have to go for. Get these hex pickoffs, find Glitter alone, just a little bit out of place, Meepo just disintegrates them in 1 or 2 seconds. Continuing to find stuff like that, keep this on top net worth and buy some time for Juggernaut to catch up and become up. Scary force in this game.
They need to really make a lot of space as it's kind of crawling its way into a 12,000 net worth deficit. But look at Hestijo, he's got Blink and Ags, and that's kind of it. Sitting behind this jug and 300 gold, Baby Knight, he's got himself that Phase Boots Manta going for the Diffusal Blade next. But we take a look, a real surprise, Sineko, who's got himself more net worth than the jug and the Centaur on the side of C9. He's going for an Ags next.
On who did you say? On the...
Sineko is going to be going for the Ags next. It looked like.
Okay. Yeah, well, he has a Lotus Storm as well, so go for that Boots Travel that we saw him go for yesterday. Whenever he is very far ahead, he likes to go for this minus into Blink into Boots Travel, so just super mobile force all over the map, constantly setting up kills. The Lotus Orb now, like you said, going for that Aghanim, so be able to save whoever the Meepo jumps on, ult them. Really like going for that item. This game does go that long. Could be a huge force, keeping heroes left with the Meepo jumps. They jump with the Centaur, they're being Omni slashed. Overall, Cloud9 have a lot of spells that really don't like being interrupted.
Vega, they're gonna get this top tier 2, but we do see Hestijo and Noia trying to tier 2 of their own down low, and down or up top, Ryze is gonna fall to G, and now the pressure is on C9 as the Macrofire gets thrown out. They're looking for an easy tier 3. Digura gonna continue to hit away at it. That is G. Get the ice path out, man style used by Digura. There's the no stop as well as those fire and the dual breath coming in. Mag's gonna get that Malphite out on Noia. And the heal is gonna be there on Digura. They're looking for these racks, and should be easy with Digura. C9, it doesn't look as though they have all too much to stop it.
Looks like they're gonna try and catch this Meepo. He's pretty far out. Ace may get caught. Sneaker with the Boots of Travel.
Black Hole used. It's gonna grab Ace again. And Digaraz here with Gene Sineko. They bring Ace down again. And 99 seconds on the sidelines with no buyback. And without that, C9, there are one finger away from falling off this cliff and calling GG.
Ace doing very good slow pushing, forcing G to come back and not allowing him to stick around and take this top racks, but this fall in the process very, very hard to not get caught, but it's Earth Spirit that can just be there from 3,000 range away with the roll as well as the blink and the kick, so does force him to come back, but falls in the process, and they may lose this bottom tower as a result, but cut it immediately back up to top and continuing to push out these lanes and walking up, siege units going to take down this tower, or at least put some chip damage. Try and trade while they take this bottom tower. With Meepo dead and no buyback, they may have to come back to defend their racks very soon.
Yeah, no Meepo for 50 seconds. It should force the hand of C9 as Vega, without a Meepo in their face, can kind of go all in on this. They don't they still do have the Aegis, and they're stunned up. Is going in a little bit of trouble there for Switcher Bass. He's going to be Yule's up. He silences the blow from Zaneko. Yule's does trade that. He's going to go in. He's going to get quite a bit as well as the Searing Chains. And there's the Dual Breath, and the Omni Swipe comes out right on G. He's going to Remnant out. They do throw a lot in the way of Vega. And G will go back to heal up and then probably Remnant back down low, where Vega will try again with this high ground siege.
Yeah, they pick up the Boots of Travel on Mag, so able to shove up this top line and then get the TP back to mid, finish off this mid tower, and then maybe get the shrines as well. Really like that pickup, and people not quite having the Boots of Travel yet, so not really able to get up to this top lane to get this pickoff on Mag. Is going to TP to the shrine and try and move up there and get it, it looks like. He may be able to find that pickoff, we'll have to see. Mag needs to be really careful as people running up.
Trying to watch both possibilities. A little bit of trouble here for Seamus. Can try and heal himself up with the Blade Fury. That's his throw out front. He's gonna be silenced. There's the Winter's Curse. Gonna buy some time for Vega. Meanwhile, SHO's gonna go down to G. They're gonna get the stun out from Seneca. G continuing to go in. There is the Lucent Beam out on Ryze. Ryze is gonna go down as well. Vega is up. Sloth 3. There's the Macro Pyre. Noy in a bit of trouble. He's gonna be very low. Lucent Beam again from Digara. It will find 4 dead on the side of C9, and the instant buybacks from both the Jakiro, Juggernaut, as well as Ryze, and they do end up getting the kill on G. So G's dead, 85 seconds, no buyback. There's BKB as well as the Lotus Orb out on Dingira. Dingira's gonna use that Manta Style, and he's gonna back off.
They do get missed one of their disables as well, so they have to be really careful. This Meepo definitely wants to try and chase him here down. And Dingira with no BKB as well.
Dingira. That BKB, there's the Ice Path on 3, and here comes the Black Hole from Maggie. It's gonna be in a little bit of trouble. The Eclipse raining down hell, but not gonna be enough to bring down H just yet. H's gonna poop on in. They brought down Zaneko. They're gonna bring down Dikyara, and a 4th will go down to the side of Vega, and now a 5th as Seema dies on the back end. The Baby Knight, it's 5 dead on the side of Vega, and this game with a good hold like that from C9 is kinda turned around.
Yeah, huge buyback ult from SHO. They committed everything, the Black Hole, the Eclipse, and then the one Meeple lives with 500 or so HP because of the Centaur ultimate. Now they march toward the base. Vega's gonna have to use a lot of buybacks. They're just gonna lose these buildings since G doesn't have them. They still end up directing the power of the Meeple building so fast.
People are gonna get stunned as well as Silence. SHO trying to go in with the Blink. Postcom not gonna find anything. There is the Hex out on Mag. Mag is gonna have that Lotus Orb up, not really doing too much. There's a stun coming out from Zaneko. He's still staying strong. Finish off that Rax and to the low ground and try and find an escape. The G is back. Here comes Rolling Boulder. Ace might be in a little bit of trouble. There's the Stun and Silence. He's trying to go in on Ace. He's getting very low. He's going to be team-weighted up and go down to G. And Mag, who's going to get the heal from Seema. Baby Knight, he's way deep right now and he does not have a healing ward or an Omni Quest to use. Meanwhile, Gigarog is going to fall again and find. He's getting very low. Winter's Curse is going to come out. Digura hitting away at SHO. SHO just going to survive with that way down. Now he's going to fall to Mag. And G might be in a little bit of trouble. He's going to have to Remnant out with that Lotus Orb as well. So they've got 2 alive inside of C9. There's the Malphite coming in from Mag. He's going to get the Blink. And they're going to get the Sludge Fist as well as the Searing Chains. The Pike is going to be used. But it doesn't look as though Noya is going to survive. And he'll be the fourth to fall.
Yeah, so using 2 buybacks, they do hold. It's a dieback on SHO now. And they do lose the set of Rax mid though, so a lot like last game, Cloud9 getting a Rax advantage just off of these small things. Sort of the Meepo effect, you get a couple of kills, you walk down a lane, and the Rax just evaporate, forcing buybacks out. And now, Cloud9 has a win condition. If they can pick off this Luna, pick off this Ursa, find a couple of kills, and they can walk down mid and maybe just throw it. Because this Meepo is so strong, has the 2 Dragon Lances to travel on E-Blade and the Hex. So Vega needs to be very, very careful about not overextending, not wasting disables, and letting this Meepo run rampant and tear apart their team. Their cores are still very, very squishy to this Meepo.
And we took a look at the net worth. It was 20,000. Vega and C9, they've cut that in half to about 10,000. Coming around the bend is Baby Knight. Gonna find Seema. He's gonna find Blink out there to heal. Which was out on Mag, but that might cause Mag to go down. There's a Black Hole only on SHO. He's gonna come through, and now SHO might be in a little bit of trouble. There's the Magnetize. SHO's gonna fall. Baby Knight's still gonna have that Blade Fury out on Mag. Not gonna really do too much as the heal is there from Kima, but G is gonna fall again. And he is dead for 96 seconds. He does have buybacks. Kima gonna go in, trying to get this kill on Noya and Will. But now he's stopped by the ice bath. And King down is Baby Knight with the Omni Slash. Will be enough. It will. And they grab two for two.
Yeah, and this G does have buyback now, as well as Seema, so Cloud9 definitely gonna force these out. They don't really know if they have them or not, so
I'm not abandoned.
Seema buyback. Maybe the G won't have to, as he will have the ult up on the winner wherever very, very soon.
We're just gonna go for this shrine thus far.
Yeah, just a couple of good fights in a row using the black hole, not using it on the Meeple. The Meeple coming in very late into these fights, with the Centaur being super tanky now, and the Dragon actually getting a few items. It takes them some time, bigger spells to kill these heroes. So,
Ega just got right at the end on Meepo, and that's why they're going in so aggressively with this smoke. They saw that it scanned red right by the Roche pit, so they know they're nearby, and with that they're gonna blink on the Ace. There's the Malphite, has to go right around the corner. Magnus has that pressure, and he does have that black hole at the ready. Noya trying to hold them back. Ace still alive for the time being, and with that, Vigor are gonna back off, and they're gonna be lucky enough to have Roche respawn right as they do.
Yeah, so, you know, G buying back to ensure that Kana doesn't get this Roche on, because if the Meepo did have this Aegis, then they'd be in a lot of trouble. They don't really have the firepower to kill him twice now. They've been winning a lot of fights.
There's the Earthbind. They do spot that Roche. It is very low. They definitely go in on this. There's the stun being used by Meepo. Not going to hit. Noya's going to get the Ice Path out onto Yara. There's the Reason Beam. Baby Knight is used. They are going to bring down Roche, and Yara will grab the Aegis. Baby Knight in a little bit of trouble, as he's gonna get hit by that Winter's Curse on him and Hester Joe. Nobody dead just yet, but here comes Tenneco. He's gonna get in with that stun. Mag's gonna be there with the black hole under the macro fire. They're gonna bring down one, they're gonna bring down two, as Hester Joe and Baby Knight die counter respectively, but Ace gets a kill on two Simulus. And now they're looking for the Ice Path down on three, and Ace is gonna find himself a kill on GG's dead for 108 seconds. Mag trying to run away. He's gonna be in a little bit of trouble. Couple more hits should do it. He's gonna fall, three are dead, and now they're looking for more. Dikira is gonna fall as well. And Vega, they've lost four, none of which have buyback, and C9, they have turned it around. They could have even just won this game.
Wow.
And GG, just like that, is called by Vega. C9 coming out of the depths of a 20,000 net worth deficit and winning this game, tying the series at one. And we will be going to a game 3 between Vega and Cloud9. Wow.